What is the future for former Vice President Mike Pence and the GOP as a whole? On Tuesday, Pence reportedly told a group of conservative lawmakers that he maintains a close personal friendship with former President Donald Trump and harbors no ill will about January 6th as Pence tries to figure out his future path. Meanwhile, Senator Mitt Romney also talking about Donald Trump and the future role Trump might play in the GOP.
He has by far the largest voice and a big impact in my party. I don't know if he'll run in 2024 or not, but if he does, I'm pretty sure he will win the nomination.
Joining us now to talk about this is CNN political commentator and former Republican Congressman Charlie Dent. Okay, let's just start there, Charlie. Mitt Romney, do you agree with Mitt Romney that if Donald Trump chooses to run again, he will win the nomination in 2024?
I do agree with Mitt Romney. Today, that would be the case. Now, over the next few years, maybe Donald Trump will diminish as a political figure, and that could change. But as of now, Mitt Romney is right. Donald Trump would win the nomination.
Let's talk about Mike Pence and his future, because he reportedly wants to run for president. When a friend sends a bloodthirsty mob after me that wants to hang me, I rethink that friendship. But Mike Pence sounds like he's different, and he has reportedly said that he harbors no ill will and that they still have a close personal friendship. What does this tell you about the future for Mike Pence and about how everybody is supposed to coexist with Donald Trump looming?
Hey, Allison, never underestimate an ambitious politician's tolerance for these types of indignities. I mean, we remember, too, Donald Trump called Senator Cruz's wife ugly and accused his father of being part of the JFK assassination conspiracy. And he's maintained as close ties with the president as he possibly can. So they're willing to do things that make absolutely no sense, in my view, from a personal standpoint. I think it's pretty horrific. So the party's in a horrible place. I don't understand why these candidates, or likely candidates, think that attaching themselves to a twice defeated politician in the popular vote, he was defeated while Republicans down ballot were winning. I mean, it means that this is a rejection of Donald Trump. They just only know how to play base politics. All they want to do is talk to the base. They have no capacity to figure out how to build a coalition to win a general election. How do they get the independents that they need? How do they pick up a significant number of Democrats? You can't do that by embracing Donald Trump. You know, it's this. They can't have it both ways.
But I mean, I don't even understand the calculation for Mike Pence. By propping up Donald Trump, isn't he defeating his own political ambitions for 2024?
Yes, and they're all making a very bad assumption that somehow that the Trump base will immediately transfer to them. I don't accept that for one second. And I think that's what this is all about. They seem to think that by attaching themselves to Donald Trump, that Donald Trump's followers will happily come along and support them. Well, we saw what happened on January 6th. A lot of those Trump supporters went down to the Capitol and were yelling, "Hang Mike Pence." So I don't think that they should assume for one second that these Trump supporters are theirs for the taking.
So Punchbowl News, their Jake Sherman has a column, basically, saying and offering evidence that the GOP is more adrift now, today, than it has been since Watergate. Even with all of the other setbacks and scandals and things that we've reported on during those decades, what do you think?
Well, I do think we are as adrift as we've ever been, probably since Watergate. The party is clearly fractured. We have those who want a clean break from Donald Trump. Let's look at Mitch McConnell and Mitt Romney, too, Liz Cheney, Adam Kinzinger, and others. They want a clean break, and there are others who want to stay attached. And I don't think that we can have this peaceful coexistence. Like I've talked about this before. There are many Republicans talking about a new faction within the GOP or outside the GOP. Some are even talking about a new party. We are at a point now where I think many are trying to make a decision about the path forward. There are a lot of Republicans like myself who want a new direction, and a new direction is not embracing Donald Trump. So I think we're fractured beyond repair at the moment, and something's got to give. Either some of the Trump people have to go or some of the people on my side have to go. I don't think there's going to be a peaceful coexistence here.
I mean, and then you have Senator Ron Johnson, who represents this, I'm sorry to say it, crazy town wing, where he resorts to a right-wing blog to get his information about January 6th, rather than the intelligence that he's privy to, rather than reading a reputable news source. I mean, he tried to claim yesterday during this hearing where they're trying to get answers as to how this happened. He tried to claim that most of the people in that crowd were jovial and friendly in their demeanor. I mean, he has fallen into some sort of strange conspiracy rabbit hole.
Yeah, it's really hard to understand why he's trying to rationalize this attack. I mean, it's pretty clear to all of us who have television sets and watch what happened, that those people who stormed the barricades and broke through, and those who, forcefully entered the Capitol and unlawfully entered it. I mean, these people, by and large, were violent and set on insurrection. There was nothing, no redeeming qualities about these folks who were part of that mob. Maybe some of the folks who went to the rally down by the White House and then went home. Okay, well, I wouldn't have been proud of my participation in that. They didn't break any laws, apparently. But trying to rationalize this, as the senator has, I don't think is a very good look. And I think he should pay closer attention to the real intelligence he is getting from law enforcement, FBI, and others.
Charlie, Dan, always great to talk to you. Thank you very much for your perspective.